Hi guys from Brooklyn, it's Melanie here, how you doing? I am being asked to give instructions on how to make spore prints. It's super easy, super fun, and really vital in helping you identify what mushroom it actually is that you have discovered in your backyard or in the woods. A mushroom is a fruiting body, so the mycelium, its roots, will still be underneath there. So pick one or two, don't go around harvesting buckets loads if you have no idea what it is you're harvesting, but one or two is great. Take it home, take it to a place like this, which is my kitchen, and start taking photographs. You need to take a photograph of the top, the cap, the underneath where it's got gills or something else, because mushrooms have all sorts of wonderful surprises hidden in them. You want to cut it down the center to see if it bruises. You want to smell it. And you want to take a spore print. Spore prints give multitude of colors, and they're really, really helpful in finding out what it is you actually have. So let's go. You ready? So one of the things I love to use when making a spore print is my big sheet of glass, which I trash hunted off the streets of Brooklyn. It's fantastic. You can see through it, so you can put it up to a window. It's solid, it's not going to break, and I'm going to zoom in now so you can just see the detail that it affords. And look at that, that's absolutely amazing. Absolutely adore it. And you can hold it up to your window if you wanted, hold it up to the dark. The kids just love it, the boys love it. So you've decided what you're going to use. You're going to use dark paper, light paper, or glass like I do. And place your mushroom down. If you're going to do half and half, place it in the center or here and here. Maybe, just remember though, you might want to frame this. So put it somewhere where it's going to be maybe in the middle so that you can maybe put other spore prints around it or leave a place for labeling it. It's always great to have previous spore prints available so that you can compare. That's fantastic. I have an old candle holder which I use as my spore print container thingy. There it is, my technical version. Put it on the center there, or you can put it here like I did when I was making this spore print, as you can see, and leave it for a minimum of 3 hours. Best is overnight, and then take off your container. I use glass. Be aware that your paper is going to be wet, so, and the spore prints won't show up quite so well at the beginning. Let them dry out, and then you're going to see the real depth and color. Even on the glass, I have to say, the whiteness didn't come up really until the spores had completely dried, and then it gave me this glorious, glorious print. Now when someone asks you, do you have a spore print, you'll be able to say, yes, I do. And post that along with the other information I gave you. Once again, I'll make another video just to give you simple, easy instructions on how to do that. I think that's about it. Let me know if you have any questions. Let me know if you have any ideas of other things about mushrooms that you want me to talk about. And good luck, have fun. So take your mushroom, place it on your medium of choice, whether it's paper or glass, cover it, leave it for 3 hours minimum, 24 hours max, and is most suggested. Take it off, let the paper, glass, or whatever it is you're using dry, and bob your uncle, as we say in England. That's your spore print. So have fun, guys. Take care. Bye.